34 says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Psalm 145 says, God is good and never failing in compassion. And Psalm 52 says that the goodness of the Lord will never fail. Do you believe it? Can I hear a solid amen on that? Amen. Yeah. Well, here's what we're going to do right now. We're going to pray to our good God. We're going to talk to him. I'm going to give you a chance to do that. Would you bow your head with me right now and let's pray? Father, thank you for your goodness. Thank you that you're a good, good Father who loves us immensely, that your love never fails. God, I want to thank you that in this room right now, there's not a person you don't love, that our sin doesn't carry us beyond your grace, that your death and resurrection is still powerful in our lives. Today, Lord, we're open to receive whatever you have for us. We pray it in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Hey, before you're seated, would you turn around and say hi to the folks around you? Let them know you're glad to see them. Well, you are in for a treat today, that is for sure. You're in for a treat. We're actually in the middle of a message series called Shadows. We're actually looking at spiritual warfare, and today I'm going to give you the first part of a message in an untraditional kind of way, where we're going to deal with one of the shadows that I think shows up in people's lives all the time. It's a shadow that brings fear. It's a shadow that can result in greed. Ultimately, it's a shadow that will rob you of blessing. And rather than today me just preaching, I thought we would talk about the testimony side of things. And in a couple weeks, I'll give part two to this message, all right? So you saw there's some folks with me on the stage. I'm going to introduce them to you. First of all, there's Pastor Will sitting right here. Pastor Will is our worship pastor. He also leads outreach ministry. That's why he's up here today, because you're going to get an opportunity to hear some of the amazing things that God's been doing because of your faithfulness and generosity. But not just yours, the faithfulness and generosity of the folks that are up here. So Kevin, who is talking while I'm talking, and it's totally okay, he's translating.
I'm trying not to be rude.
He's translating. Kevin and his wife, Tani. Tani, would you just wave, stand up, do something really big, let everybody know?
Yeah.
Kevin and Tani lead a ministry called Ancient Paths. They are the missionaries that live in the United States but make the ministry in Cuba happen. The way things happen because of the Cuban government and all that stuff, it's important to have somebody on the ground here who can make the ministry happen. And last year, we supported Kevin and Tani in the ministry they did in the most profound ways. But what's really cool on the stage right now is Jose and Jan.
Pero lo mejor, sí, dice que lo mejor en este momento es usted.
Yeah, oh, there you go. All right. Jose and Yami. Jose and Yami, they lead an incredible ministry in Cuba. God has blessed their church, their faithfulness. On the stage, you have an example of people who have been faithful in small things, and God has done great things in them. When we talk about shadows, one of the things you have to keep in mind is that there'll always be an opportunity for you to be unfaithful in the small things. But if you're faithful in small things, God will elevate your life and bring blessing to you. That's what you're going to hear right here in their lives. So guys, welcome to the stage. Would you four corners help me welcome them? Just a round of applause. We're glad you're here. Take it away.
Hey, we're so glad that you're with us. We believe there's no better place to be on a Sunday morning than right here, right in this place. And today is extra special. But before we begin, we kind of want to do a little gift giving from our church to Pastor Jose and Yami. So I got three things, Kevin, that I want to give to you that give to them. So here we go. We got two T-shirts that are pretty sweet. Pastor Jose arrived in the U.S. wearing our older gray Real Love Now T-shirt. So we're going to update a little bit there. Those are yours. We have two scarves we brought back from India, from the orphanage that we partner with, that we built. So these two scarves are both for both of them.
Bufando de India, de la casa de huérfanos allá.
I'm excited to see Pastor Jose wearing that scarf. That could be pretty cool.
Sí.
You got to pick the color. I don't know. That'll be good. Yeah.
O quizás esto.
Maybe. I don't know. And we also have two Bibles, leather-bound, for them. It's in English, but...
¿Alguna Biblia en inglés hay que aprender?
So, hey, we're so excited to welcome both of you and Kevin as well. It's going to be an awesome morning. So we're going to kind of kick it off, Ben, and let's roll this.
Well, before we do a whole lot of chatting with Pastor Jose and Yami, I think you need to meet Kevin. Some of you have met him before.
Kevin.
So, Kevin, tell everybody a little bit about how it is you connected with Jose and Yami and the work in Cuba. Don't take forever.
I was going to say, I'm looking at the clock. Okay. Yeah. All right, let's give you the short version, okay? The short version of this is that 12 years ago, for the first time, I went to Cuba with a friend thinking that my life would not change. I'd be there for a week and come home, and that was it. And I went to Cuba 12 years ago, November 2006, and God showed me something miraculous, that I actually had a brother, like real brother, to be explained later, sitting there waiting for me to know him in Cuba. And from the very first moment that we were together, there was no choice but that we were going to be in ministry together, and now we still are.
It's really awesome how God has used you, your wife, Tani, your family. How many times have you been to Cuba in the last few years?
I have made 24 trips to Cuba in the last 12 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And most recently, you went to Cuba with our folks.
Yeah, yeah. And most recently, I went to Cuba with a group of 9 amazing people from Four Corners.
Woo! Yeah, yeah. We're really happy about that.
Dile algo del grupo de Four Corners.
Bueno, yo estoy muy bendecida por estar en este lugar.
God has blessed us greatly to be here.
Y cuando conocí al grupo que nos visitó en septiembre.
And when I came to know the people that visited with us in September from Four Corners.
Gente tan linda.
They are just beautiful people.
Tan llena de Dios.
They are full of the Lord.
Yo sabía que venían de un lugar de la misma manera, un lugar lindo y lleno de Dios.
God knew that they were going to be sent out to a place that's just like that, beautiful and full of the Lord.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Hey, what I want to do is I want to go ahead and jump straight into the work and the ministry that's happening. But what we know in our church is that usually before God does a profound work, he calls a person.
Uh-huh.
I mean, God works through people,
sí.
Right?
Dios llama a personas.
Yeah, and so what I thought we could do is just share a little bit about the testimony of how Pastor Jose and Yami found the Lord, how the Lord found them and began to call them into ministry. So would you just take over this part and help us get some of that testimony out of Pastor Jose and then Yami?
Give her a preacher a microphone, son, and take over your stage. I love you, man. Okay. Entonces, explica a la gente esta mañana alguno de tu testimonio.
Bueno, yo conocí al Señor siendo muy joven.
I was a young woman when I came to know the Lord.
Fui criada en una familia católica.
I grew up in a family in Cuba where we didn't know the Lord.
Y siendo una adolescente, el evangelio llegó al pueblo donde yo vivía.
And so when I was an adolescent, the preacher of the gospel came to Cuba.
Y allí conocí a Cristo.
And through that woman, I became to know Christ.
Bien joven, experimenté que realmente Dios había resucitado, está vivo.
I was about 15, 16 years old when I really experienced the fact that the Lord has been raised from the grave and God is alive.
Y que gracias al sacrificio en la cruz, hoy yo puedo ser templo de su espíritu.
And so, because of his sacrifice for me in the cross today, I can be a temple of his Holy Spirit.
Es bueno que los jóvenes sepan esto.
It's a good thing for young people to know.
No importa la edad que tengas.
It doesn't matter what age you are.
Dios quiere encontrarse contigo.
God wants to be with you.
Tú puedes conocer a Jesús.
You can know the Lord.
Y tener experiencias maravillosas con él.
Yeah, and God can give you great experiences.
Solo Jesús puede llenar el vacío de nuestros corazones.
And so he wants to find the way into your heart.
Porque fuimos creados para eso.
Because we were born for
para
this.
Tener una relación profunda con nuestro
we
Dios.
Were born for a deep, rich relationship with the
y
Lord.
Yo tuve esa relación.
And God can do that. In
conocí a Cristo.
You should come to know
realmente
him.
Lo conocí.
Yeah, I have come to know him, really know him.
Y aunque muchos trataron de desanimarme.
And so many people in that time tried to dissuade me from this.
Y me decían que habían lavado mi mente.
And they said I must have been out of my mind.
Mi experiencia había sido real y profunda.
My experience of God as a young person was real and deep.
Y fue algo que nada ni nadie pudo robarme.
And it was something that no one and nothing could steal
porque
from
Dios
me.
Porque Dios había revelado a mí.
Because God had really revealed himself to me.
Yo sentí un llamado especial de Dios.
And I felt at that time as a teenager a very special calling from
que
the Lord.
Todo aquello que estaba experimentando y viviendo,
that everyone would be able to live and experience God's
los demás debían
presence.
Conocerlo.
That they would know God's wonders.
No podía callármelo.
I really didn't have much to help me
tenía
out.
Tenía que hablar.
I didn't know how to talk.
Tenía que decirle al mundo.
All I knew was I could go out and say to the world.
Gritarlo si era posible.
All I knew was I could go out and
Jesús
shout
es real.
That God was real.
Nos ama.
That he loves us.
Y tiene cosas grandiosas para
and
nosotros.
And then he has huge things for us.
Y Dios me llamó siendo muy niña.
And he called me when I was young.
Para hablar a otros lugares.
And he sent me out to other places to speak of him.
Comencé a sentir en mi corazón compasión por almas que se estaban perdiendo.
And I started to feel this great compassion in my heart for souls that were being lost.
En los pueblos alrededor donde yo vivía, nadie conocía la buena noticia del evangelio.
And so God sent me out to places where no one had heard the good news.
Y yo comencé a sentir en mi corazón la necesidad de ir a esos lugares.
And I felt it necessary. My heart just started telling me it was necessary.
Era algo más fuerte
there.
Que yo.
And so I went there. He said,
y fui. Con la bendición de mis pastores fui.
And so with the blessing of my pastors, I went.
Y recuerdo que en mi primer lugar donde evangelicé, llegué a ese lugar sin saber siquiera predicar, sin saber teología, homilética, nada de eso.
And so the first place I went, I didn't know anything. I didn't know how to talk, I didn't know how to preach, I didn't have any homiletics, I had nothing.
Pero sí sabía algo.
But I knew something.
Lo que yo estaba sintiendo,
I knew that what I had been
feeling, estaba viviendo,
I knew that what I'd been living,
era real.
I knew it was real.
Dios es real.
God is real.
Y el mundo necesita saber eso.
And the world needs to know that
Jesús
God is real.
Vive.
Jesus lives.
Y él quiere que tú y yo tengamos vida en él.
And he wants us to have life in him.
Él vino a desplazar el imperio de la muerte.
He came to bring us out from the
y
dead.
Y darnos vida en abundancia.
And he wants us to live in abundance.
Y comencé a tocar puerta por puerta.
And so I went around knocking on everybody's door.
Y decirle a todos cuán bueno ha sido Dios conmigo.
And I went to tell everybody how great God had been to me.
Y sé que solo es la gloria para él.
And I said, you know, listen, all this glory is for the Lord.
Porque aquellas personas escucharon la voz de una joven.
Because for whatever reason, some people started listening to this teenage girl knocking on their door.
6 meses ya había una congregación de más de 100 personas.
And in 6 months, I had a congregation gathered of more than 100 people.
Y yo era su pastora.
And all of a sudden, I was their pastor.
¿Qué iba a hacer?
What am I going to do?
Pues de rodillas.
Right? I got on my knees.
Yo le decía al Señor, dime qué hago.
And I kept saying to God, please do something.
Y Dios cada día.
Tell me what to do.
Cada día su Espíritu daba la palabra que yo debía compartir.
And every day the Holy Spirit gave me a word.
Y las vidas comenzaron a conocer la luz de Cristo.
And these lives of these people started to know the light
la
of Christ.
La verdad de Dios
the truth
llegó
of the
a los corazones.
The truth of the Lord began to arrive in
la
their hearts.
La salvación llegó a través del sacrificio de la cruz.
Salvation came to them through the sacrifice of Christ on the cross.
Después de esto conocí este hombre tan lindo que tengo al lado.
After this I came to know this very handsome man sitting next to me. Gracias. Gracias, Johnny.
Nos conocimos estudiando, tuvimos la oportunidad después de unos años de estudiar algo de teología.
After a few years of working, I got the opportunity to do some theological study, and that's where I met Jose.
Y ahí comenzamos una amistad.
And so we started out as
una amistad.
Y usted sabe, nos enamoramos, esas cosas que pasan.
Then we started a friendship, we're just friends.
Y Dios nos unió.
And God brought us together.
Dios nos unió con propósito.
He brought us together with a purpose.
Ambos habíamos sido llamados a lo mismo.
I mean, we really, both of us felt the same calling.
Ambos habíamos tenido la misma experiencia.
We had the same kind of experiences with God.
La necesidad de llevar el evangelio, la buena noticia.
The need to go out and take the word, the good news to people.
Ambos bien jóvenes.
We were both very young.
Tomados de las manos.
We took hands together.
Comenzamos a depender totalmente del Espíritu Santo.
And we started together to depend completely on the Holy Spirit.
Para ser instrumentos en su obra.
So that we could be instruments in the work of the Spirit.
En todos estos años no sé cómo, pero Dios se las ha arreglado.
And we don't know how, but God really put things in order.
Para que en el ministerio cada uno ocupe su lugar.
So that in every place everything was put in its place.
Él es la cabeza.
He's the head.
Pero Dios nos ha unido en propósito.
But God brought us together with a purpose.
Ambos caminamos juntos con la misma visión.
Both of us walking together with the same vision.
Ambos juntos.
Both of us together. Because the wife,
Dios te quiere
the
en el llamado de tu esposo.
Uh-huh. The Lord loves you as you love your husband.
Porque esposo,
and for the husband,
Dios te quiere en lo que llamó a tu esposa.
And God calls you to love your wife.
Cuando Dios une a una pareja,
when you're together as a couple,
Dios tiene propósito.
God has a purpose for you.
No estamos aquí por casualidad.
We're not here by accident, people.
Dios no te llamó por casualidad.
He didn't call you by accident.
No eres una casualidad.
You're not an accident.
Hay propósito de Dios para tu vida.
There's purpose from God for your life.
Solamente hay que descubrirlo.
All you have to do is find it.
Y con tu matrimonio,
and if in your marriage,
hay propósito en Dios.
There is purpose
en
in your marriage.
La obra de Dios.
There is purpose in the work of
juntos,
God in your marriage. Together.
Juntos somos más fuertes.
Together we are stronger.
Amen. Me voy a caer un ratito.
That's awesome.
Now you know Yami.
That's awesome. Hey, Jose has as well an amazing testimony of.
Y Pastor Jose también tiene un testimonio asombroso.
Yeah,
specifically,
I'd love for him to talk a little bit about the challenges of growing up and not being able to go to school and what he had to do instead.
En tu juventud, ¿cuál eran los retos para usted? Creciendo como un cristiano.
En nuestra juventud fue difícil.
In our youth it was difficult.
Producto a que vivíamos tiempos difíciles para los cristianos en Cuba.
We were living in those days in times that were difficult for Christians.
Después de los 59 en Cuba comenzó un periodo de persecución, un periodo difícil para la iglesia.
We had grown up in a time of persecution. It was difficult for the church.
Y crecer en Cuba siendo un joven cristiano era muy
And in my youth, it was a very, very difficult time to grow up as a Christian youth.
Muchas veces a muchos se nos puso la, pudiéramos decir, la posibilidad de estudiar estudios universitarios si solo negabas tu fe en Jesucristo.
Many of us were offered the opportunity to study at the universities if we would negate our faith in Christ.
Pero gracias a Dios que muchos en ese tiempo pudimos tomar la buena elección.
But
de tener a Jesús como nuestro Señor y Salvador por encima de todas las cosas.
But we're grateful because many of us were able to make the right choice and follow Christ.
That's incredible. And how?
Este es increíble.
How did Jose know his call to ministry? How did that happen?
¿Y tu llamado cómo conociste?
Bueno, pertenezco a una familia de cristianos de ya una segunda generación.
I was a second generation Christian.
Mi familia conoció al Señor en los años 40.
My family came to know the Lord in the 1940s.
Una misionera americana, Leora Shang,
an American missionary woman named Leora Shang,
fue a predicar a este lugar donde mi familia vivía en el campo.
She came to the farm village where my family lived to bring the word.
Pertenezco a una familia de campesinos que sembraban arroz, la tierra.
We were a family of farmers. We planted rice.
Y mi abuela conoció al Señor y de ahí toda mi familia ha conocido al Señor.
And my grandmother came to know the Lord and she brought the rest of us into the fold.
Como mi esposa decía, desde jóvenes conocimos al Señor.
Like my wife was saying, since we were young, we came to know the Lord.
Y en lo personal fui a una oración contestada de mi mamá.
And so for me, my mother prayed a specific prayer.
Ella no podía tener hijos.
My mother couldn't have kids.
Y como Ana, le oró al Señor.
And so she came to pray to the Lord.
Durante 9 años ellos trataron de tener hijos y fue imposible para ellos.
My parents tried for 9 years to have children and couldn't.
Mi mamá un día le dijo al Señor, si me das un hijo, te lo voy a entregar todos los días.
And my mom said, okay, listen, if you give me a child, if you give me a son, I will give him to you for all of his life.
Y el Señor le contestó la oración.
And so this is God answered her prayer.
A partir de ese día fui consagrado al Señor.
And so I was consecrated to the Lord from the day of my birth.
Y quiero decirte algo que aún desde pequeño mi mamá y mi papá me llevaban a la iglesia.
And from the time I was a very little boy, my parents took me to church.
Pero solo a los 11 años fue que yo tuve mi primera experiencia con el Señor.
But my real first experience was when I was 11 years old.
A los 11 años, en un campamento de jóvenes, le entregué mi corazón a Jesús.
I went to a camp and gave my heart to the Lord.
Quiero decirte en esta mañana, uno no nace siendo cristiano.
I said, you know, nobody just becomes a Christian.
Tenemos que enseñarle a nuestros hijos que ellos, a pesar de que nazcan en un hogar cristiano, tienen que
tener esa relación personal con Jesús.
We have to teach our children that even if they're born into a Christian family, they have to come to know the Lord for themselves.
Y después de ese tiempo, pues comenzó un trato fuerte del Espíritu Santo de Dios con mi vida.
And so the Holy Spirit started to do very strong work in my life after.
Había un llamado especial a esto, a predicar a las almas.
And I started to get this calling to preach.
Y con 17 años el Señor me hizo un llamado muy especial, muy particular.
And he gave me when I was 16 years old a very, very, or 17 years old, a very specific calling.
Me estaba hablando de un lugar que era donde yo vivía.
He was talking to me about taking the word to the neighborhood where I lived.
Recuerdo que esa noche en un tiempo de vigilia que tuvimos con los jóvenes.
I remember one night we were in a youth prayer vigil.
Alguien se acercó y me empezó a dar una palabra de parte de Dios.
And somebody came to me and started to bring me a prophetic word from the Lord.
Y me dijo, el Señor te está llamando a que tú comiences a predicar la palabra en el lugar donde tú estás viviendo.
And they said to me, the Lord is calling you to bring the word of God to this place where we're living.
Y estamos hablando de los años 90.
We're talking about the early 90s here.
Y desde los años 50 en ese lugar donde yo vivía nunca antes, nunca más se había predicado la palabra.
And since the 1950s the word had not been preached in this town.
Y estuve un año completo resistiendo ese llamado.
And I spent an entire year resisting this call.
Hasta que tuve que rendirme.
To the place where I finally had to give it up.
Nos reuníamos en un apartamento en un cuarto piso que era mi casa.
We lived in an apartment on the fourth floor of an apartment building.
Allí en poco tiempo.
And so right there with
el Señor comenzó a traer a muchas personas.
God started bringing a whole lot of people in a very short period of time.
Habíamos como 70 personas reunidos en el balcón de la casa, en la sala, en el baño, en la cocina,
en la escalera. We had like 70 people that were everywhere. They were on the balcony, they were in the living room, the kitchen, and the bathroom. They were everywhere.
Y aquello era una locura.
It was crazy.
Y así, como mi esposa decía, desde muy temprano comenzamos a sembrar la semilla de la palabra del Señor.
It's like that. So from very early on, God started to plant his seed in us and work.
Talk about, by the way, I'm blown away by this. I don't know about you guys, but talk a little bit about the ministry, where it is today, and the opportunities and the challenges.
Hablan ustedes un rato del ministerio hoy, cómo estamos en este momento y los retos para el ministerio en este tiempo.
En este tiempo estamos trabajando y ministrando en Jovellanos.
Right now we are working and ministering in our hometown of Jovellanos.
El próximo 11 de enero cumplimos 8 años nuestra iglesia.
On January 11, 2019, our church will complete its 8th year.
Desde el año 91 habíamos comenzado a plantar varias iglesias en diferentes lugares en Cuba.
From 1991 forward, Yami and I have been called to plant churches in different places.
Pero hace 8 años el Señor nos hizo un llamado especial a este lugar de Jovellanos.
But God gave us a very special calling 8 years ago to this place in Jovellanos.
En esta región de Jovellanos es muy fuerte la santería.
Very, very, there's a very strong presence of the voodoo-based religion Santeria, which is mixed with black magic and witchcraft and things like that. Very strong presence of this spiritual darkness in our hometown.
En la época de la colonia de España,
in colonial times,
España trajo muchos esclavos africanos a nuestra nación.
Spain brought many, many slaves to our country.
Y uno de los lugares en Cuba donde más esclavos habían era en esta área de Jovellanos.
And in our city, Jovellanos, it's one of the places where most of the slave camps were gathered.
Por lo tanto, en esta área la santería tomó mucho más fuerza.
And therefore, this Santerian religion that was brought in a different form
el
from
área,
Africa is strongest in our
esta
region.
Esta zona donde estamos nosotros ubicados es el área donde viven la mayor cantidad de sacerdotes de esta religión.
And so the neighborhood where we have located, where we have planted our church is the neighborhood where most of the priests of Santeria live.
Nunca antes en este lugar había prevalecido una iglesia, nunca se había progresado una iglesia.
No one had ever been able to put a successful church in this neighborhood before.
Era un lugar también considerado de oscuridad, de violencia.
It was also considered a violent neighborhood. It was a place you didn't want to go.
El Señor nos dijo, es tiempo que mi luz resplandezca también en este lugar de Jovellanos.
And so the Lord said to us, you know what, it's time for my light to shine over there.
Y comenzamos un trabajo barco misionero en ese lugar.
And so we started a missionary work to that neighborhood.
¿Por qué les digo misionero?
So why do I say missionary?
Casi siempre nosotros la iglesia llegamos como conquistadores.
Oftentimes the church shows up in a given place like a conquistador.
Y siempre tratamos como de demostrar e imponer un poco nuestra fe.
And oftentimes we want to demonstrate and impose our faith on the neighborhood.
Y la fe no se impone.
But you can't impose faith on people.
La fe se muestra, se recibe a través del amor de Cristo.
You have to show faith, and people have to receive it.
Y el Señor nos dijo, solamente quiero que ustedes vayan y muestren mi amor, sean parte de ese lugar, amen y respeten a esas personas.
I want you to go over to that neighborhood, said the Lord, and show them my love, right? Become part of the people there, and then offer them.
Y quiero decirles que hoy, gracias al Señor,
and I want to tell you that thanks to the Lord today,
contamos con una iglesia preciosa,
we have a precious church,
una iglesia poderosa en el poder del Espíritu de
we
Dios.
Have a church that's very, very strong in the power
más
of the Holy Spirit.
Más del 80% de nuestra congregación fue sacada de la santería.
More than 80% of the members of our church were rescued and pulled out of the santería.
Este ha sido un tiempo de también a través de este lugar poder mostrar a la comunidad de jovellanos que también la luz de Cristo puede traer cosas buenas a nuestra nación.
And by what God has done with us in that neighborhood, we've been able to show to the people of the whole city the power that God has to change lives.
¿Por qué? Porque nuestra nación por mucho tiempo ha estado sumergida en tristezas, en escasez, en necesidades.
For many, many years, our nation has been submerged in sadness and difficulty and need.
Pero en Cristo Jesús estamos completos.
But in the Lord, we are complete.
No terminados, pero completos.
We're not finished yet, but we're complete.
Y el gozo del Señor,
and the joy of the Lord,
ha sido más fuerte que cualquier necesidad.
Has been much, much stronger than any need, whatever need.
Y la paz de Jesucristo en nuestros corazones,
and the peace of the Lord in our hearts,
ha sido más real que cualquier problema que se levante delante de nosotros.
It has been more real than any sort of problem that could be raised up.
Hemos aprendido a mirar al cielo y confiar solo en Jesucristo.
We have learned to look upward to heaven and trust only in the Lord.
Estamos enfermos, Él nos sana.
If we're sick, God heals.
Él puede hacerlo.
And He can do it.
Nada hay imposible para Dios.
Nothing is impossible for the Lord.
Y se lo dice a alguien que en un momento de su vida necesitó un trasplante de corazón.
There was a moment in which I was told by my doctors that I needed a heart transplant.
Y que estaba condenado a morir.
And that I was condemned to die.
Porque para el hombre no había solución para mi problema.
Because for humanity there was no solution for
pero
my
Jesús
problem.
Me dijo,
but Jesus
no has de morir.
Said, listen, you're not going to die.
Has de vivir.
You're going to live.
Y has de vivir para testificar las cosas grandes que yo puedo hacer.
And you're going to live to testify to the great things that I can do.
Conocemos a un Dios que nada lo detiene.
We know a Lord that no one else has.
Un Dios que todo lo puede.
We know a God that can do everything.
Un Dios que hace milagros todos los días.
We know a God who does miracles every single day.
Un Dios que para él.
We know a
nada
God.
Imposible.
We know a God for whom nothing is impossible.
En Cuba hay una iglesia alegre.
In Cuba, the church is joyous.
No hay una iglesia pobre.
We're not a poor church.
No, a pesar de tanta carencia.
In spite of all of the difficulties.
Somos ricos en el Espíritu.
We are rich in the
tenemos
Holy Spirit.
Tenemos tanta abundancia en el Señor.
We have so much abundance in the Lord.
Que no tenemos palabras para agradecer.
We don't even have words to thank Him.
Porque Dios nos ha dado la mejor parte.
Because God has done great things for us.
No hay nada mejor.
There is nothing greater than
que ser lleno por su Espíritu.
Than to feel His Holy Spirit at work.
Que vivir una vida a los pies de Cristo.
To live your life at the feet of Christ.
Y ese es tu Cristo.
And this is your Christ.
Ese es tu Dios.
This is your God.
Hoy te puedes sanar.
Today He can heal you.
Hoy te quiere liberar.
Today He can free you.
Hoy te quiere levantar.
Today He can lift
hoy
you up.
La bendición de Dios quiere llegar a tu vida, a tu matrimonio,
he
a tu
wants
familia.
To bring His blessing to your life, to your marriage, to your family.
Es necesario creer.
And it's just necessary to believe.
Y dejarlo orar.
And to pray.
Amen.
All right, so there's this amazing church. The Lord's doing great things.
Uh-huh.
You see why I opened with being faithful in small things?
Entiendo por qué yo comencé con las cosas pequeñas.
When you're faithful in small things, God does great things.
Fiel en las cosas pequeñas.
When you're faithful and small. And so, like, for some of us, I know we're like in the middle of this shadow series, and this doesn't really sound like it, but I'm showing you pragmatically how shadows are destroyed. Faithfulness in small things brings the great things of God into your life. It's just true. I mean, they didn't know all that God was going to do in their life. They only had a call, and then they began to walk in obedience. And when they walked in obedience, God began to open doors. And for the next few minutes, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you some of the breadth of the ministry. And then as a church, we're going to have an opportunity to step forward and help them. Last Christmas, we helped them. We're going to help them again this Christmas. But you're going to leave today with an opportunity to help as soon as you hear some of the stories of some of the partners they have in ministry. So let's talk about some of the pastors that they've come alongside, equipped, and are helping do ministry throughout Cuba.
Vamos a hablar de las misiones y pastores.
En este tiempo, nuestra iglesia no solo ha crecido en la ciudad de Jovellano.
So our church hasn't just grown in the city of Jovellano right now.
Dentro también de la ciudad de Jovellano tenemos varios lugares de predicación.
In addition to our church inside the cities, we have 10 places where we bring people together.
Estos son casas de oración donde muchas personas que no van a la iglesia pues llegan a estas casas y comienzan a escuchar la palabra del Señor.
They're prayer houses where people who have never heard the word can come and hear the word and have people pray for them.
La función de estas casas de oración es llegar a conectar esos pequeños grupos con la iglesia madre.
The idea is to connect these small groups of new believers to the mother church.
Pero también el Señor nos estuvo hablando de poder salir y extendernos a otras regiones de la provincia.
But God's also been talking to us and saying, get out of here and extend the mission.
Y en este momento contamos con 12 misiones fuera de la ciudad de Jovellano.
And so outside of the city of Jovellano right now, we have 12 mission sites.
Muchos de estos lugares, la visión es que lleguen a establecerse iglesias como la nuestra en estas regiones.
And so the idea is for us to go out and establish churches like our own in those places.
Hay algunas de estos lugares, de estas misiones que están en ciudades de nuestra provincia.
There are some that are in cities in our province.
Pero en la mayoría son lugares de campos, lugares pobres.
But most of them are out in farmlands in poor areas.
¿Por qué estos lugares de campo?
So why would we go out to these farmlands?
El Señor nos mostraba cómo muchas veces las iglesias grandes, las grandes denominaciones solo tienen puestos tus ojos en lugares donde quizás la iglesia pueda ser próspera.
He said, sometimes we've seen from the Lord how a lot of the bigger denominations and those people only want to go to the well-populated areas where it seems easier to bring a church
together. Pero el Señor nos daba una palabra específica y me decía, tengo mi arco tensado apuntando a esos lugares pequeños de campos olvidados.
He said, but God's given us a very specific word. He said, I've got my bow and arrow aimed at these very specific places out in the fields where
y quiero decirles que Dios está haciendo cosas tremendas en esos lugares.
I want to tell you, God's doing tremendous things in these
places. Nuevas
congregaciones
se están levantando y muchas personas están aceptando a Cristo.
New congregations are being raised up and many, many people are accepting the Lord.
Le damos gracias a Dios por eso.
We thank God for that. Y los pastores. ¿Cómo mantenemos un equipo de pastores?
Bueno, eso es...
It's difficult to maintain a team of pastors to do this work.
Les estábamos diciendo que en Cuba una de las situaciones las que estamos enfrentando como iglesia.
One of the things that's confronted us in Cuba as a church.
Es cómo poder sostener y enviar a pastores.
How do we raise up and send out pastors?
Y la situación económica muchas veces no nos ayuda para que podamos sostenerlos completamente.
And the economic system does not help us to sustain ministry very
Así
well.
Así que nuestra iglesia no se ha cruzado de brazos.
And so but in our church we haven't just sat back and crossed our arms and waited.
Y de nuestros diezmos y ofrendas pues tomamos parte de eso y damos una pequeña ayuda para que esos pastores puedan ir.
And so from our own offering, we do our best to take a little bit and use it to send out pastors.
Y muchas veces estamos escuchando, bueno, ¿cómo pudiéramos hacer la misión de Dios?
It's like, and we, oftentimes we hear people ask the question, how would we be able to do the mission of the Lord?
Y el Señor antes de nosotros llegar aquí a los Estados Unidos me daba una palabra y me decía, díselo al pueblo de Estados Unidos.
The Lord gave me this word right before we came and said, tell this to the people in the U.S.
Quiero decirte algo.
I want to tell you something.
No estamos esperando que pase algo para nosotros hacer algo.
We don't have to just wait around for a time to come for us to do something.
Nosotros estamos caminando ya.
We are walking already.
Estamos siendo esos lugares.
We are going to these places. We are being
Estamos haciendo
places.
Nuestra parte.
We are doing our time and our work.
Y el Señor me decía, diles esto.
God said, say to the people in
La
the
misión
US,
se hace
You do the mission work of God
con las rodillas de los que oran.
With the knees that pray.
Sabes que es necesario orar.
You know, it's necessary to pray.
Orar por esas personas que van a esos lugares.
You got to pray for the people who are going out to those
Orar
places.
Para que el reino de Dios no solo se estanque en este lugar, sino que se pueda expandir.
Yeah, you know, we're not supposed to get stationary and stinky in one place. We're supposed to extend.
El Señor nos decía, las rodillas son necesarias.
So we need the knees that pray.
Pero me decía, necesitamos también las manos de los que dan.
And we need the hands that give.
Aquellos que proveen para que otros puedan ir.
We need the people who provide so that others can go.
Y el Señor nos decía también, es necesario también los pies de aquellos que van a ir.
And we need the feet that will go out and do.
O sea, si juntamos estas tres cosas, la rodilla, las manos y los pies,
the knees, the hands, the feet,
pues vamos a ser un gran equipo.
Then we're gonna be a great team together.
Y ese es nuestro sentir en esta mañana.
And this is what we're feeling this morning.
Esta es nuestra visión en esta mañana al llegar a este
lugar. This is the vision that we have for this morning.
Decirles que en la India están trabajando.
We know that you guys are working in India.
Ustedes aquí en los Estados Unidos están trabajando.
And you guys right here in the United States are working in India.
En Cuba estamos trabajando también.
We are working in Cuba.
Y juntos podemos ser un gran equipo.
And together we can be a great team.
Ayudarnos a sostenernos los unos a los otros.
And we help each other to sustain one another.
Podemos hacer que el reino de Dios se extienda y pueda construirse grandemente.
And if we do that, we'll be able to see the kingdom of God extended in the world.
Tú puedes ser un colaborador en el reino de Dios.
You can be a worker in the work of the Lord in his kingdom.
That's so good. So last Christmas, we gave an initial infusion. And we're going to ask the Lord, you know, God, show us what the future is for this. Tell us a little bit about what happened with that money. We gave just a brief hint, but just tell folks a little bit about what God did with that.
Ah, I can do this. Me voy a explicar de su ofrenda en la Navidad pasado. I'll start. First of all, your offering, it was beautiful, and we thank you for it. And the first thing we used it for was the purchase of piano, so that they could make beautiful music like you've got here. So we bought a piano that went there. We put several thousand dollars that money into construction that's going on in at least four of our sites right now. There's construction going on. Construction will always be going on because of the way we have to build. You have to find a property, buy it, and then build a space, right? Or renovate a space. So that's always going on. Your dollars went into specific construction projects at the home church, La Senda Antigua, and in a mission quarters we are building. Then we were able to take a large portion of that money, and they're going to explain what we did with it this summer. La Misión Misericordia este verano. ¿Qué hacemos con su ofrenda?
Este verano pudimos tener un viaje misionero a la provincia de Oriente.
Because of your offering, we were able to take a mission trip of our own, a mercy mission, out to the poorest part of the island, the East End.
Esta es una de las regiones más necesitadas de la nación
It's
de
Cuba. One of the areas that has the most need in all of the island.
Este año tuvimos el sentir de ir a ayudar y sostener a varias familias de pastores allá en esta región.
We went out. God gave us the sense that we would go out with a project to help pastoral families out at that end of the island.
Y pudimos llevar una ofrenda para comprar muchos artículos para la cocina y el hogar.
And so we were able to take up a large offering from many churches in the U.S. and from our own church, including 4C.
Y esto para las familias es muy importante.
And we were able to take some basic things to them, very important things for their families.
Cuando llegas a estos lugares te das cuenta que muchas de estas personas no tienen artículos para su cocina, sino que cocinan con madera.
A couple of years ago when we first went out there, we saw that most of the families didn't have basic home appliances. Instead, they were cooking over wood fires.
Se pudieron ayudar a 118 familias pastorales.
And so we were able this summer, with your help, to help 118 pastoral families.
Esto trajo un impacto tremendo en cada familia.
We were able to give them what you would call an Instapot, which isn't trendy in Cuba, but it has been the thing for decades, right? And a traditional pressure cooker, right? This is an incredible impact for these homes.
Esto es no solo materialmente, sino espiritualmente.
Not just materially, but spiritually as well.
Esto es una región muy apartada y difícil de llegar.
It's a region that's very difficult to get to. It's mountainous and it's separated from the rest of the
Creo
country.
Creo que de esta manera el Señor también les dijo, ustedes no están solos, no están olvidados.
And this was a way that God was able to say to those pastors who serve in these very difficult conditions, you're not alone, you haven't been forgotten.
Yeah, that's a big
so
deal.
So we thank you.
Yeah, we can give it up for that. That's awesome. So this Christmas offering, which will begin for us pretty soon, we're going to again partner with our partners now in Cuba. We'll also be doing our work in India and our local work as well. But the opportunity today is to get a head start. Now, this is not for everybody. In fact, I've only got five of these. Only five of these right now. But we've asked Pastor Jose and Yami to identify some of their pastors, families that we could help mechanically every month, financially. So what happens is if these pastors, by the way, they don't get paid. This is not their job. And so they have to work 24/7. They have to work round the clock to just take care of their family. We're offering, if you'll help us, the opportunity for them to receive some money once a month from us that allows them to dedicate hours of their week to ministry so they don't have to earn a living for their family. And we're talking $60 to take care of a family a month. And so we want to do five of those. That's how we want to begin. They've got dozens that are possible, but they've identified five that are urgent with the highest potential, they believe, to do incredible work. And so what we're going to do is give you an opportunity. How that's going to work mechanically is this. On your Connect card, Next Step E, if you're a guest, that's the card you filled out to begin with. You just put a checkbox on Next Step E. I'm going to go over that again in a few minutes. Next Step E says, send me the information about sponsoring a pastor's family in Cuba. It's $60 a month to do it. What we need is a year commitment at a time, so if you can't do a year, this isn't for you. It's not for everybody, but we didn't want to miss the opportunity to go ahead and start helping. Now, in our church, when you sponsor a kid or you sponsor a pastor's family, you either have to write a check for the year or you have to automate your giving every month. Again, this can't be something you just feel in a moment. It has to be a commitment. Because once we say to these families, we're going to take care of you, we're not willing to cut them off. Just like we never say to an orphan, we'll take care of you, but we're going to cut you off because somebody got mad and left, somebody couldn't manage their money. So we need to have a reasonable sense that money's actually coming in. So if you want to do that, next step E is your step. That's the first way you have an opportunity to respond. But there's another way I want to give you an opportunity to respond. When Will goes into worship in just a few minutes and we celebrate together the goodness of God, I've asked Pastor Jose and Yami to stand down here by the stage and offer prayer for people. And specifically one of two categories, just one of two categories. If you believe God has put a burden on you for mission work so that you can be one of those sending people, you can help make missionary work happen, and you'd like to receive prayer for whatever's going on in your life, we'd love for you to come up and receive prayer during the song. And that requires a certain amount of boldness. You can also write your prayer request on your Connect card and we'll pray for you. But I thought that if you're one of those people who feel uniquely impressed by God to help do mission work, that it might be meaningful for you to have these missionaries pray for you. So that's category one. Number two is, I just had a hunch that maybe there's one or two people in our room who feel like maybe you have a missionary call on your life. And if you feel like you have a missionary call on your life, I don't want you to miss the opportunity to receive clarifying prayer. So you're not saying you're going to be a missionary, but you're wrestling with it. This is not the first time you felt it. But it's been stirred up and the fire's been stoked today. When God's church is healthy, people get called to ministry. That's what happens. Leaders step up. And a sign of a healthy church is leaders step up and they pick up the mantle of ministry. Now, selfish Christians can't do that. Selfish churches can't do it. But healthy churches do it. So I want to give you a chance when we sing again in a few minutes to go ahead and come forward for prayer and just ask God to give you clarity of your steps if that's your thing. So you're a sender of missionaries or perhaps you're wrestling with mission work and you're wondering if God has his hand upon your life to do that. And we want to cover that in prayer. This is the work of the Holy Spirit. It's a special thing that God does for a handful of people. And so normally we try to hit everybody in a service, but today we're focusing on the mission work. And so how does this relate to our shadows? I mean, let me tell you one of the best ways that God breaks the shadow of mammon and greed and fear is he gets people excited about ministry. Now, we're going to talk more mechanically in 2 weeks about it, but he gets people excited about ministry, and they use their life to give to the kingdom. They are faithful in small things, and God does great things with it. And I'm telling you, trust me, listen to me. I'm telling you that the stranglehold on a lot of your spiritual life is you have not yet stepped into ministry with your life. When you do that, God's going to open a door for you you've never known before. It's going to bring blessing into your life. It's going to bring favor on your life. It's going to bring challenges on your life, but the power of God will work in your life in ways you've never seen before. And what the enemy wants, he wants to keep you struggling with your day-to-day life so you can never even think about the kingdom of God. And we're standing against that as a congregation today. That's what we're doing. And I'll explain more mechanically in a couple weeks about what happens with this whole money dynamic. But the first thing I want you to understand is that if you're faithful in small things, God will give you great things and make great things of your life. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to model what I want you to do. So practice in my life has been whenever I've been around great men and women of God, I just ask them to pray for me. I think it's the only way I've made it as long as I've made it. So, if it would be okay.
I got
one more thing I got to say to that.
Muchas veces pensamos,
many times we think,
que vemos la bendición de Dios en nuestra vida cuando todo está cómodo, cuando todo está bien.
We think we see the blessing of the Lord in our lives when
cuando
everything's good,
las
when
cosas
everything's
están a la mano,
when everything's right in hand.
Cuando vemos que Dios bendice nuestra casa, nuestra familia.
We think then God's blessing our house and God's
pero
blessing
hay otra
our family.
Manera de ver también la mano poderosa de Dios.
But there are other ways we can see the hand, the powerful hand of God.
Y es cuando tú te levantas y comienzas a dar ese paso fuera de la barca
when
en
you
fe.
Get up and you start to take a step forward.
¿Quieres ver la mano de Dios en cosas sencillas o en cosas grandes?
Sometimes God works in simple things, sometimes God works in great things.
Pues yo creo que llegó el tiempo de Dios para ustedes aquí en esta nación.
But I think it's time for you guys here in this nation.
Comenzar a veces a salir un poco de nuestra vaca.
To sometimes to just start to get
de
out of
nuestra
the boat
comodidad
a little bit.
Y comenzar
right?
a dar ese paso como Pedro fuera de la barca.
Get out of your comfort zone and step out where like Peter did where it's uncomfortable.
¿Quieres ver la mano de Dios en todo?
Because you want to see
comienza a dar ese paso de fe.
If you want to see God's hand move and everything, you've
el
got to
paso
get out
de fe no
and step
es cuando
out
las
faith.
Cosas estén ya listas.
You can't step out in faith when everything's ready in front
el
of you.
Paso de fe es cuando todavía no veas nada.
It's when you step out in faith when you can't see what's going
y
on.
Ahí es donde podemos ver la mano poderosa de Dios
actuando. You want to see the strong hand of the Lord work?
Solo el Señor te llama y te reta. Atrévete en este día.
You got to step out in faith.
So here's what we're going to do. Let's go ahead and call your team up. You guys get ready. Why don't you guys grab out your connect cards?
Okay, entonces,
let's take a couple steps. Hang out right here. Hang out right here.
Ustedes queden aquí.
If you're our guest, the reason everybody else around you is moving is they know that at the end of our service, we take steps. We don't just hear a message and get stirred. We actually try to put it into action. We believe that you hear the word and then you do the word. So that's what we're doing right now. And I think it'd really honor the Lord if we gave everybody in the room an opportunity to make sure your heart was right with God right now. And so if it's not, next step A on your connect card says this. It says, I am making Jesus my Savior and Lord today. The Bible says if you put your faith and trust in Jesus, not the work you did, but in the work he did on the cross and in his resurrection, you can have eternal life. We'd ask you to, in just a moment, pray with me, but check that box with the pen. And we'll follow up with you about what it is to follow Jesus, but in a minute, we're going to pray and give you a chance to do business with God and make sure your heart with God is right. If you came in here today without a relationship with the Lord, you can leave with one. The next step B is today I'm choosing to be baptized. If you want to be baptized in our church, we'll celebrate with you the great work that God has done. You just check the box, and we'll follow up with you through the week. Next step C is a prayer. I'd love for everybody in this church to pray. It'll get you ready for the part two of the conversation we're going to have about mammon, kind of the god of money and stuff. Here's what it says. I'm going to pray this prayer each morning. Father, help me to be faithful in the little things so that you will be able to do great things through my life. Help me be faithful in the little things so you can do great things through my life. Next Step D says, I'll pray that God will raise up faithful leaders to join Jose and Yami in their work in Cuba. If you check this, we'll send you some ways you can pray for them and some names and some stuff. All you got to do is check the box, make sure we can read your email, and we'll send that to you in your email this week. And then Next Step E, like I told you earlier, says, please send me the information on sponsoring a Cuba pastor. Send me the information on sponsoring your Cuban pastor. Now, in our church, the way we receive these Connect cards is, if you're our guest, you just put them in the offering bucket when it comes around. So if you call this church home, this is your opportunity to support the ministry here. We're going to support them through the Christmas offering. And if you want to go ahead and write a check to Four Corners and put Cuba on it, we'll dedicate it towards that Christmas offering and go ahead and get started on that, even though we're not ready to unveil everything yet. But if you're feeling stirred, you can help with that. If you think you might want to support one of those pastors, make sure Next Step E is checked. But if you call this church home, I want you to understand how the power of faithfulness in small things has made a difference here and now. In our own church, here and now, we've seen God do amazing things when people have, as Jose said, gotten on their knees and prayed to the Lord, opened their hands to give, and caused their feet to walk in the direction God's calling them to do. So for almost 15 years, we've seen the faithfulness of God here. And one of the most exciting things for me as a pastor is to serve a group of generous people like you so that our reach reaches all the way to India, Cuba, and literally down the street as well. You're a good church. God's not done with us. And I want you to be a part of it. Let's pray about our next steps and our offering. And then I'm going to ask Pastor Jose and Yami to pray for me. Jill, would you join me, please? I'm just going to tell you, if I've learned anything in ministry, I've learned I can't do it without God. I cannot do it without God. So when they get done praying for me, we'll have them stand right down here. And if you would like to receive prayer, you can do that while we're praying. Pray with me. Father, thank you. I lift up right now, Jesus, those men and women who are declaring, save me, Father. Wash away my sins. I trust the work of your cross and your resurrection. Lord, I lift up the work in Cuba. I pray that your spirit would do its profound work in that place. God, I'm grateful that we can open up our hands and we can be a part of what you're doing. God, I pray that you would make us even more ascending church. That you would break darkness off of people's lives as they get the light of the ministry call upon them. As they see clearly the power of God at work in the world, it opens their hearts for the power of God to work in their own lives. Lord Jesus, do your powerful work in this place. Amen. You're welcome to give in the offering. Jill and I are going to turn around and let them pray for us, and then we're going to sing.